Hey guys, it's Kelly here again and welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to my November bullet journal setup. First things first, I'm going to show you my October setup, which was ostrich inspired, and it was a fun, quirky, doodly spread that I thought was cute and interesting and more or less unique. So if you want to check it out, it is up on my channel, but here is a quick flip through of all of my trackers and spreads so you can get an idea. Now, for my November one, I went with a dreamscape kind of theme. At least that's what I had in mind when I was creating this. It is loosely inspired by a painting I did a couple of months ago, which I think I also have a video of that. It's a watercolor painting with some purple clouds, and I think it turned out so magical and so beautiful. I just had to share it, and I also had to try and recreate it in my bullet journal. Now, I've mentioned before that the paper on my bullet journal is not the greatest, so it doesn't handle a lot of inks and a lot of markers, not even the regular ones, but I managed to keep it kind of simple and kind of get the effect that I wanted without it having to ink onto the page behind it. And how I did that is I used this lighter purple color, and I put a base on, and while it was still wet and the ink hadn't absorbed yet, I went in with the dark purple and just dotted a few dots here and there, and the ink would just spread on its own because the surface was already kind of wet. And I would be just really careful how much I put from the darker ink so it wouldn't leak onto the other page. The first one was kind of a test one where I just, you know, kept turning back to see if it leaked or if it ruined the pages behind it. And it was on the verge of doing that a few times, but altogether it had a pretty decent. So I am happy with that. I did try it on the back of my bullet journal. If you ever want to try something and see how it looks and how the paper of your journal handles it, the back of the journal is usually where I do that, just so I can test the paper, because as I mentioned, my paper is not that great. But yeah, so I'm going to put on the screen and in the cards, maybe in the description bar, the video for my watercolor drawing that inspired kind of this whole theme and setup. And yeah, I'm really happy with how it turned out. It's very different. I do really like the effect that I got because I managed to achieve it without actually using watercolor, just two regular markers. And I think it turned out really cool and different, and I am pretty happy with it. It's a little bit dark, but at the same time, because it's just the accents, I kind of dig it, you know? It's kind of tumblery. I don't know if that's still a word. I don't think the younglings here on YouTube are very aware of Tumblr or what it used to be, but in my mind, it kind of seemed tumblery. So I made quite a few mistakes in this journal, like you're going to see on my overview page with the calendar. I added two extra days at the end. I ended up going over it with a white gel pen, but you can still kind of see it because it's a very dark purple color and it's pretty obvious. But you know, at some point I don't care. It's messy, but I like it. Now, I have a bit of a situation here in my personal life, because I created this at the end of October and I don't actually have it. I don't have my bullet journal with me and I can't actually fill up the spread. So that's gonna be interesting. I think this spread is going to remain absolutely empty. Not even one day is going to be filled in, because I live alone. I've lived alone for a couple of months now, and the idea was that my parents are going to come and live with me for a couple of months because they're doing a renovation on their apartment. So because they're doing a full reno on their apartment, they had to move out and move their stuff. And for a couple of days during the last week of October, I was actually at my boyfriend's while they were bringing in boxes and setting up, so I didn't actually get to meet them in the apartment. And the last day when I was with my boyfriend and I was calling my mom, because we had a situation at work, we had a person who was positive for COVID, and I was waiting to see, because I hadn't met with my parents, I was waiting to see if that person was indeed positive or just had symptoms. And I waited a couple of days, and when the last day we figured out that, you know, she didn't just have symptoms, but her test came out negative. So I called my mom and was like, okay, so she's negative, should I come home? And she was like, you know what? I don't feel that great. I feel a little sick, so you should stay at your boyfriend's for a little while, just so we figure out what's wrong with me. And it turned out that my mom was positive for COVID, and she actually got sick. And when she did, I ended up, well, practically displaced, because I hadn't gone home. And when she told me that she wasn't feeling well, I didn't go back home. So I stayed with my boyfriend. I literally had the clothes on my back. I had like nothing here. So I've been living here for a couple of weeks now. I think it's almost 3 weeks, and my mom is still kind of sick. She's doing well. She actually did quite well in the beginning. She had a high fever for 3 or 4 days, and after that she also coughed a lot, and she said she felt very tired and exhausted, and she had muscle pains. But that was like the first 3 or 4 days after she started showing symptoms. Then after a couple of days, her test came back positive, and she was quarantined. My dad was also tested, because they're together, and his test was negative, but he did have symptoms. He was coughing, which is, I think, weird, but I mean, it's weird for his test to be negative and for him to be coughing, because he doesn't cough at all. And so he had some kind of symptoms. She wasn't feeling well, but the doctor prescribed her antibiotics, and she drank antibiotics for a couple of days, and she felt completely fine. After like 4 or 5 days, she was like healed. She was absolutely normal. She had no symptoms. She felt great. And basically after, 10 or 12 days after the first symptoms were shown, she started feeling sick again. So now she's not well again, and she's dealing with fever once more and coughing, and she doesn't feel great, but I am hopeful that she's going to recover and she's going to be okay. So that's kind of what's been going on. Sorry if that kind of bummed you out. I really didn't mean to. It's just the situation right now in the world. It's not just me, it's not just, you know, people you hear about on the news, it's absolutely everywhere. And just, you know, stay home when you can, and always wear a mask when you're in public, because you might not get it and you might not show symptoms, or you might show very minimal symptoms, but there are going to be people who will go through it in a very hard way. And personally, I don't want to be the reason for somebody's suffering, and I'm sure a lot of people out there don't want that either, and they don't want that on their conscience. So that's basically all, I guess, on this subject. Just stay safe, wear a mask, and care for people, because I think that's the most important thing, and that's what is lacking in the world right now, the caring portion of our humanity. So yeah, please keep my mom in your thoughts, and so that she can recover quickly, and enjoy this spread. And if you want to recreate it, just feel free to do so, and show me in the comments. So that's difficult mumbo jumbo out the way. This is a flip through of the whole spread. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, I am sorry if I bummed you out and it was a bit of a harder topic, but you know, it is what it is. So we carry on, we venture forward, and we try to spread care and creativity in the world. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.